What if you could live forever digitally? Imagine creating an AI replica that doesn't just sound like you, it remembers your stories, teaches your lessons, and shares your wisdom with future generations. This isn't science fiction, it's Sensay. Hey everyone, I'm Jamie, and welcome back to Teachers Tech. Today we're checking out Sensay, this really cool platform that lets you create lifelike AI versions of yourself. Yep, you heard me right. These digital clones can do all sorts of things, from helping people with dementia by offering familiar conversations to acting as a personalized tutor that adjusts to different learning styles. You could even use Sensay to monetize your expertise. Imagine offering on-demand advice without actually being there. Sensay is all about pushing the boundaries of what AI can do, helping you preserve your legacy and making life a little bit easier in some pretty amazing ways. So let's dive in and see how it all works. Let's go check out my Sensay now, where you're going to see the one replica I made, and then I'm going to walk you through creating your own. Just to point you out, I am using a professional account that Sensay gave me access to so I could test everything out. You can check out the different pricing. There is a free account one that you can use as well, but it doesn't have all the bells and whistles that I'm going to show you today. So let's start it with the end in mind here, and I'm going to go to my video avatar to show you kind of what we're aiming out at. And then we'll kind of work backwards from there to show you how you create this. So here's my digital replica. This AI replica of myself is curated with the information that I gave it. I gave it some stories of childhood, some memories. I also gave it some knowledge base from websites and YouTube videos. And I did make up the stories of the past, but it will give you an idea of what this can do. So let's have a little conversation right now with him. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on the mic and ask about a story from their childhood. Hey, can you tell me about a story from your childhood?
I grew up in Saskatchewan, and one of my favorite childhood memories is riding my bike down a long gravel road behind our house. I was about 6 when I hit a rock, flew over the handlebars, and scraped my knees. It taught me resilience as I got up and tried again the next day. Do you have any memorable stories from your childhood?
So I could have a little bit of a conversation now with him, like just normal AI context. So this story was something I created. I know it's pretty cheesy, but I could put anything in. And this was just from text putting it in. Now I also connected it to a website about astrophysicists. And so if I asked an astrophysics question or just generally what about it, hey, what can you tell me about astrophysics?
Astrophysics is a science that uses the principles of physics and chemistry to study astronomical objects and phenomena. It covers a wide range of topics, including the properties of dark matter, dark energy, black holes, and the overall structure of the universe. It's a fascinating field that seeks to understand the universe's origins, evolution, and ultimate fate. If you have any specific questions or areas you're curious about, feel free to ask.
The last question I want to ask it, and it's about a YouTube video I gave it about AI and machine learning. So I'm going to ask it right now, what do you know about AI and machine learning?
Artificial intelligence AI is about simulating human intelligence using computers. It involves learning, reasoning, and inferring. Machine learning, a subset of AI, allows machines to learn from data without explicit programming. It identifies patterns and makes predictions based on data. The more data it has, the better it can predict outcomes. If you have more specific questions, feel free to ask.
So this is just a little example here of information I curated to feed to my replica that it would become an expert at or knowing me with my digital legacy. But let me show you how you go about creating all of this now. If you want to check out more replicas, you can take a look up here. So if you go to replicas, you can get an idea. They have the different voices for each of these. So for example, if I click on Albert Einstein, you can have a conversation with Albert Einstein. And when I hit play,
good day.
You could either
you
read
find
it.
Yourself in conversation with none other than Albert Einstein.
And you can have questions back and forth with it. So you can play around with those different replicas. I'm going to go back to my Sensay here. And when you go ahead and create, you can see you can create character replicas, create your own character replica, or you can create business replicas. And I'm just going to do create a replica here, and then I'll walk you through setting it up. I already have a personal replica created here, and so I can't create another one. I could delete this one to create another one, but I'm going to come back and show you how I did train this replica. But if we're going to go create a new one, you can see I have a character replica, and I could also do a business one. Let's go to create a character. And in this case, I'm going to create just a kind of a quirky knight here called Sir Chatslop. And I'm going to generate an image for this character first. So I already have something planned that I'm going to put in. So a quirky futuristic knight named Sir Chatslop wearing shiny high-tech medieval armor. So I'm just going to go ahead and generate this. I think this will fit quite nicely here. I'm going to go and click Save. As I go down, I want to say, what's the name? And I said, Sir Chats-a-Lot. What type of description do I have? Well, I'm just going to call him this right here. Your friendly, overly enthusiastic digital knight. And we need a phrase. So I'm going to say the phrase is going to be this one right here. Hail, noble one. What quest shall we embark on today? Gender, well, I don't think it really matters, but we'll go male here. And then we have our Sensay replica handle that will get created and some tags. So, you know, in my mind, I think I was thinking comedy, but they don't have that one here. So I'll just pick lifestyle and maybe we'll pick a little bit of philosophy as well. So as I go through, you can see I can make this public or private. So if you're sharing this to outside, you'll want to make this public. And what's going to be the tone or personality? So I'm going to go ahead and add this right here. So Sir Chatslot speaks like a medieval knight who's time traveled. Sure. You can see there's a little bit of information that I created for this. I'm going to go and create the replica. Looks like I forgot one right here that I can go ahead and put this. So I'm going to go and put the Sir Chatslot for the handle here. So we'll put this right here. I'm going to go back and make sure this is the handle right here. You can see it's approved. Now I can hit create my replica. Now underneath my personal replica, you're going to see the character replica here. And this, I can start training it just like I did my other one. Here's some information I'm going to feed this character, just some funny stories. You can see like the day that fought the Wi-Fi dragon. And this isn't a Word document, but I need to save this as a text file that I already did. So I can go train from files here. So I go to it and I just need to upload that file. So I have this one called Sir Chat and I'm going to click open. Remember to make sure this is a text file. Then it goes through and it starts to add this to the memory. So I can see now it's ready. It took that information in. If I go back, I'm just going to go back to my Sensay here. I'll go back a couple spots here. And now I gave it a little bit of memory here. So if I go and let's say I want to have a conversation, remember, I don't have a video avatar with this one yet. If I click on it, I can copy this and I could go and paste it to chat, or I can just click chat here. So if I go to the chat and ask, tell me a story, and I'm just going to ask it to tell me a story here. So I'll just do this and see what it gives me back. Now at this point, it's telling me about the tale of the missing remote. And that was one of the items that was in there. So if I look, I can see where this is cited at this point. So you get an idea how the memories are starting to be formed from how you curate that information. And you can see, I don't have all the things set up. I don't have a voice set up here, or I don't have the video avatar. So I'm gonna go back to my Sensay here, like my personal Sensay, and just talk to you about some of the things I did here and how I set up my video avatar. Let's look at the way you can train these replicas now. If I click on train from YouTube, you'll see where I added two videos to here. With the pro plan, I can add 500 videos. So you can get an idea of how much information that you can put into your replica. So I put these two videos. As I mentioned, one was about astrophysics and the other was about AI and machine learning. And it goes through and takes that information out. Now, and you just have to go ahead and add the links. You can train from files, like I showed you. I uploaded a text file there. You can train from the web. So with training from the web, here is the astrophysics. It's just Wikipedia. I could add a lot more different websites in there to even gain that knowledge. So if you want your replica to be as smart as in any subject, you could just go ahead and put that information you want in there just by adding the URL. We have the video avatar. I'm going to come back to that in a moment, but I want to talk about adding your voice. So if I go to chat here with myself and it remembers everything here, if I go and just listen to the message, you can see this pops out down below.
Artificial intelligence, AI, is about simulating human intelligence using computer.
It has a voice very similar to mine. So if I go back here, I'll just click on my Sensay. I had to train my voice, so I added my voice. So if I go click add my voice, I went through, I did a recording just through my mic right here, but I can upload a recording. So I would just go, I went through and record audio. I talked for about 20 seconds each. I probably could talk longer and add better quality audio to even make my voice sound better, but I just added these and that's how it would read that information with my voice. Very quick process. Now with the video avatar, what you need to do is actually use go to another site, and that's Hey Jen. So with the video avatar, you'll see that down below here, there's a couple of keys in here. So I'm going to open up Hey Jen and show you where I created this. So for this first API key, I would go to HeyGen here, and I needed to go ahead and pull from my settings here. If I click on space settings, I have an API key and I'd have to copy it and go back and paste it over here. So that's one step. But I created my own avatar in HeyGen. So I go back and I'm not going to walk you through the whole process. I just want to point out where this is. And this is something I did pay for in HeyGen as well. But if I go down towards the bottom here where it says labs, and we have these interactive avatar. So at this point here, I could have taken from the public avatars, I could have used one of these avatars. I could go ahead, get the avatar ID or copy it over. But I have my own avatar that I went through and I clicked create interactive avatar. And I went through and just filmed myself for about 2 minutes. For the first few seconds, I was just looking at the camera, pretending I was listening. Then I just talked for about a minute and a half, making sure there was breaks. And then I just stared at the camera at the end. So it took this and it took about a day to create. And then I get this avatar here. And then I got the avatar ID here. And I went back and just pasted it over here. Now, the last thing I want to talk about training is train with Athena. So we've taken all these other sources, but you can go through here and what it's going to do is ask you questions about yourself. And you just go through and answer this, and this will add to the memories that it has about you. So the conversation that you get in with your digital replica, it will know these things. So if I go back here and I click on memories, this is the information from Athena. I can go back and edit or delete this information as well at this point. If you're ready to share your replica, you can share with this link. So like I showed you before, you can share this to other people. When you open it in a new tab, you will see it right here. And when you share it and you have all those different features with the video and the voice, all of this will be available down here. So if I go ahead and click on the video, then my video interactive avatar will come up. And I can go ahead and start, hit play, and just like I showed you before, you can interact with this. Now, I do want to point out, you do have an embed chat, so you can embed this with a website. And you can also use the QR code here, right here, if you want to share this as well. Make sure that you have your replica set to public if you want other people to view it. With Sensay, it's not just about creating a digital twin. It's about preserving the essence of who you are, your stories, your lessons, your legacy, living on to inspire, educate, and connect with others. So what would you teach your digital replica? If you want to check out Sensay, the link's down below in the description so you can start playing around with it for free. Thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.